On the hills above the Gallipoli Peninsula, where more than 2,300 Kiwi troops are buried, silence was broken. An opportunity to remember family who experienced the horrors of war.
So I've had great grandfathers that fought in the First World War, the name Pohatu. I've had uncles fight in the Second World War in the 28th Māori Battalion and are buried in Italy, right down to my dad, who was a career veteran and who passed away about 6 years ago. And I know this would have meant a lot for him.
Acknowledgement too, the fight for freedom that the Anzacs endured is a living reality for the Ukrainian people.
While we're here reflecting what transpired and what shaped our nation here in Gallipoli, is, like you say, still much amongst us today. In this international climate, we always pray for peace.
After a moment of remembrance, a stirring haka from the New Zealand Defence Force. The Māori contingent was 400 strong when it landed at Anzac Cove in 1915.
Their job was to go forward at night and to pinch out various small Turkish outposts which were guarding the foothills up to Chunuk Bair, which was the objective of the offensive. They did that job magnificently. It was described as one of the outstanding feat of arms of the whole campaign.
A bloody campaign with mounting casualties. At Chunuk Bair, a final rehearsal of remembrance. Watched on by these Turkish students who travelled 8 hours, showing the Anzac spirit is in no danger of fading. We're very proud to hear our own anthem and nice to hear the New Zealand anthem, 15-year-old Savalda tells me. We've learned a lot about the Anzac war history in school, but this trip has made it even more special. As the final touches are being put on the Anzac commemorative site, the physical reminders of a painful past now help educate and bring people together.